Having a content-heavy screen in an e-learning course is a complete no-no. You should actually ban screens like this in your e-learning courses completely. So what do I do when I have screens like these where I have some information which is critical and which is related? Now here I'm talking about the new features and I want to talk about all of them at one screen. But if I put all the information here, I really disappoint my student because they have to go through all of this in one screen. We need a solution where the learners can click on some button and get information related to each of these points one by one and not at one go. And a solution for this is to add an accordion interaction using Captivate 6. Let's see how we can add an accordion easily into a course. Let me just add a screen here and I will add a new slide. And here's our slide. I will say new features and I will delete these placeholders because I don't need them. So these placeholders are gone and I have the title here. To add the interaction, I have to just go and click insert interaction button here in the tools panel, or I will go to the insert menu and here I will select interactions. Once I do that, I get the select interaction panel from where I can select the required interaction. For this screen, I need an accordion. So I will select accordion and click insert. Once I do that, I get the configure interaction dialog where I can go enter text, change the theme and customize the interaction. Let's start with adding the text to this interaction. So I have this text already available over here in this text file. So I will just go and add this text here in these buttons. It's very simple. You just have to double click and this text will be updated from what you copy and paste. You can even simply type in these sections. So let me just quickly do that for you. Now I updated the text for these four buttons, but how do I get one more button here? It's very easy. You just have to click the plus button and it will give you one more button in this accordion and it will be added here. It's also very easy to delete a button. You just have to double click it and then click this minus sign and it will delete that particular button from your accordion interaction. Let's add it and add the content here. So this is the last text that I need to add and this is the last content. So I have created this interaction and my buttons are ready. Now I can easily change the theme of this interaction to match with the theme of my project. So let's select one of the themes here. We can either go with this or let's look for some black interaction. I think this looks good, but this goes well with my theme that I have. So I have chosen this particular theme and now I can even customize the look and feel and the color of this particular interaction. What I can do is I can go to custom and I can change how the buttons look like. So I can change the color for these buttons. I have an option to choose the up, over and active button states. So here over, let's make it a little dark brown so that it goes well with the border of this particular interaction. Let's choose the closest color. I will choose this one. I think this goes well. Or you can even bring in the color value and add here. So whatever color value you have for this interaction, you can easily add it here and it will provide you that particular color. So for now, I'll just leave it here. Otherwise, you can go and add. Also, now you can see it's instantly updated. You can also change the text. You can change the font size. So if you want to increase the font size of these buttons, all I'm doing is I'm scrolling the wheel of my mouse. So just scroll the mouse wheel and it will allow you to change the size easily. You can even put the text in the in using left orientation, middle, or the right orientation. So whatever suits your requirement, you can do that. Also, you can change the font here for the up, over, and down state. So if you've using some use some different drastic colors for up, over, and down, you can easily come and change the color for the text from here. You can also customize the content that goes inside these buttons. So you can change the color if you want. You can also change the background color. So if you want that instead of white, it should be some other color, you can easily go and change it from here. So I'll for now change it to white. And then you can also change the text. So here you can see that it's just 13 points. I can increase it to say a 16 point or a 15 point so that it's readable for the learners. I can also change the font family and the style for the content. I can also change the background color, the body background color from here. Also, I can change the header. The best part here is if you don't want this header, you can easily remove it. In the page, you saw that I had already added a header where I said new features. So I don't actually need to mention the title again. What I can do is I can go and switch it off by clicking here. So it will give me only the interaction and it will remove the header and the directions for me. So I can just have it comfortably placed in the content area and it doesn't disturb the look and feel of my overall course. So I do that and everything goes off. So my interaction is ready, and once it's ready, all you have to do is click OK and the interaction will be placed on your screen. Once you place it on your screen, you can even resize it to fit it to your screen. So I'll just resize it and see that it's comfortably placed inside this chalkboard so that it doesn't disturb the design. So I've resized it. But after resizing, keep one thing in mind that if you have resized it, just click this refresh widget so that all the distortion that has happened inside the widget because of resizing will be adjusted and you will get a fresh looking widget. So once you've refreshed it, this button will go away automatically. And if you feel that there is something you need to update, simple, just select the widget and click widget properties and you will be taken to the properties panel where you can again go and make changes to the text, font, color, or anything. So this is how you can add an accordion. There's one more thing that that's very interesting and I didn't show you here in this interaction. Let me show it to you in some other file. So here I have a project which I'm doing for health industry and I have a similar accordion, but this time I don't want text to be available to be read. What I want is when I click on the accordion button, it should play audio and show an image. So no content, nothing. I just want to play some audio. So let's see how we can do that. I'll click an interaction here and it allows me to add an accordion. I get the configure interaction dialog and here I can choose whichever interaction type I'm looking for. So let me just select this one and now I will start modifying it. So I have the text file where I have all the details. So I have the title. I will change the title here and I have the directions. I will triple click and add the directions. And now I have these 3 points. Make sure visitors clean hands. So I have all the directions written nicely. And then in the audio, I'm talking about the further details about it. So I'm quickly placing it and let me do it for the rest of the two as well. And then we will go and add the audio and images. So we've done this and this is the third one and quickly paste it. This is done and I don't need the fourth label, so I'll do a double click and I'll delete it from my interaction. So I have this ready. Now what I have to do is I have to go to section one, delete the text because I don't need it, and then I will click on the add audio button to add the audio file here. And then navigate to the correct folder to get the audio. So this is for my first button in the accordion. I will just open it.
Make sure visitors don't have the opportunity to spread an infection by get.
I've muted the audio now, and you can see that as soon as the audio file was added to the accordion, it started playing. So you can make sure that the audio is added correctly to your interaction. Now, after adding audio, I will add the image. So I'll again go to import and I will select the relevant image and it's added. Now you can either place it towards the right or you can place it towards the left. Here I don't have any content, so I can comfortably place it towards the left. I can do it for the second button as well. I will just delete the text, add audio, and here's my audio file, and the voice is muted, so you won't be able to hear anything. I'll add the image and place it towards the left. Then go to the third one, delete text and audio. It's as simple as it can be. So I've added the audio here again, and here comes the image. My interaction is ready to rock and roll. So I have this ready, and once I click OK, the interaction is added to my course. So whenever you have such content heavy slides, don't worry, use an interaction like an accordion or a tabbed screen or anything else that suits your content type, and you'll be really happy to see the results. Thank you for watching this tutorial.